हेलो गर्ल्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे इज़ आवर क्लास ऑन एम्बेडेड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। सो वी हैव सीन द एम्बेडेड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड ओपन सोर्स एम्बेडेड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन, विच इज अवेलेबल एज पर द कर्नल आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ कर्नल्स, राइट? यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी हैव सीन कोजो, दैट इज कॉन्टिकी फॉर द मोनोलिथिक कर्नल आर्किटेक्चर, then tiny os for the monolithic, and cognity is for the modular kernel architecture, a tiny os is for the monolithic, and ritoz is for the rito is for the microkernel activities, right? So now today's we'll see the introductions to the real-time operating system, right? Real-time, that is called the ORTOS. What do you mean by the real-time? Real-time has any operating city. It is not a faster or it is not a slower, but that particular task has to be performed within a time, or within that event, that is called the real-time operating system. Now, what is the ORT? Before that, we should first understand what is a operating system, how it is work, that we have seen, but just a brief review. This is your hardware, right? For general purpose system, this is your hardware. On top of that, it is operating system. This window is operating system windows. Everybody knows that, right? On that top of it is your application program. Now the example has taken the MS Office. So these are the application program. And on that MS Office, on that it is a user. User are accessing the MS Office. So it is operating system is the interaction between application program and the hardware. So why it is used the operating system? To manage the particular resources, to manage the CPU also, to manage the memory also, to manage the event, and all these tasks is used by using a operating system. So this is your operating system. Now what it is purpose, that what is an operating system? User, applications, operating system and hardware, all these are the interface to each other, right? So now what is a user? User are accessing a software. It is a software layer, but the hardware and the application software which, right? Operating system, it is what? It is a software layer between the hardware and the application software. This is what? It is a software. Operating system is one kind of software, but it is a layer between the applications and the hardware. Has direct access hardware. So now this operating system is directly accessing the hardware, but application cannot access directly hardware because it has to go through the operating system, right? So manage hardware according to the predefined rules and policy, right? Rules and policy means scheduling, resource management, memory management, all these are the rules are there. So operating systems are managing complete hardware according to the predefined rules and policy. Hide hardware complexity for the application software. So whatever the hardware complexity, it is hiding from the application software. What, just ask that what you want exactly. So whatever the, just if we go to the restaurant, the kitchen is there, the waiter comes and they just take the order what you want. You don't allow to see the kitchen is there out in the backside of the your restaurant, right? But what is going on there? Because that is completely hiding from the user. What is the need of user? It has to tell to the waiter, and waiter is a operator. That is called the operating system. Same as the application doesn't interact directly hardware. It is the it is hiding a hardware complexity from the applications, right? That is the job of operating system. offer multitasking resource and data management, right? It use the multiple tasks, and that for multiple tasks, it how the CPU resources are management, how the memory is management, what are the overlaid, how the data management, everything is done by the operating system. So each and every system has their own operating system, whether it is a single operating system or multitasking operating system, but each and every system has a operating system, right? Now these are the basic example: Microsoft Windows, Linux, these, and Mac OS. Mac OS is used for the Apple laptops or Apple computer. Linux is the for networking and general use, and Microsoft is used for the general purpose operating system. These are the desktop operating system, or Android, iOS. These are two operating system are the mobiles operating system, right? And the third categories of operating system is the embedded operating system, right? So now today we will going to see the real-time operating system is a part of the embedded operating system. Now what is the real-time operating system? That is called RTOS, right? So RTOS is designed specially to run application with very precise timing and high degree of reliability, right? High degree of reliability. It is not faster or slower, but whatever the applications need a time that has the high degree. Suppose if you go to the ATM, you put your card there, you put there your PIN number, you are withdrawing money. Within a time, you will get the message on your mobile. That within a time is your real-time operating system. Understood? It is within a time your account balance is minus by whatever amount you have withdraw from the ATM. Right? That is called the real-time operating system. Right? It takes time. It is not faster. It is not slower. But it has a specific time. Within that time, it task has to perform. Right? RTOS. There are two times. High degree reliability. Why high degree reliability? Because if you are withdrawing a money and that is not minus by your account, so it is very inconvenient system, right? It may go to the loss, so that has to be a reliability, right? So if you are taking money, so that has to be a minus from your account, right? So high degree reliability. So RTOS means what? It is real time plus operating system. Real time means within that time plus operating system, that is called your real time operating system, right? Now what are the real time systems? So real time system are those system which respond to the external event in a timely fashion, right? External event in the timely fashion. Just now I have given the example, if the money is withdrawn within that minute, your account should minus by that withdrawn money and SMS should reach to you, right? So it is timely fashion, and it is external event. It's something for the not the internal system, it is for the external event, right? A real-time system is characterized by the need to meet the deadline within that time, within that deadline, it has to perform. It is called the real-time. I'll take you the examples. What are the real-time operating system examples, right? So real-time performance does not mean the faster performance. It is not mean the faster or the slower, right? It is mean that whatever specific time is given, within that time, the system has to operate, right? That is called the real-time system. We call it as in a real life and real life, right? So this is actually time-driven operating system. Now, these are the two types of real system. One is the hard real system and one is the soft real system. Suppose if you don't get the SMS, but your life is not that much hazardous, right? Your balance is minus. But if you get the SMS after 2 minutes, yeah, after 2 hours or next day because of the network issue and all, but that is not a hard real time. It is a soft real time. Soft real time is that could be a manage if it is not get the manage. But hard real time means it is not managing. It has a difficulties. You have to loss for the life or something more hazardous. So that is two kind of operating system. Real time. It is hard real time and the soft real time. Hard real time means what? A system that meets the deadline all times 100%. All time 100%, right? There should not be a error in between. That is a hard real time, right? Even under the worst case system loaded, even worst to worst case, if you are in the flight, I will take that example also, but they are using a hard real time. Within that time, task has to perform. So it is hard, 100% deadlines to meet. 100% deadline, whatever the condition, that has a meet 100% deadline. Missing a deadline, even a single time, may result the fatal consequence, right? Even it is a single 0.1% error, but the result will be a fatal consequence, right? The hard real-time system are used the life safety system, right? It is a life safety system where the task need to perform within a particular time frame. Otherwise, the catastrophic event will occur, right? Just airbags, right? If the your accidents are there, right? And then your car driver seat, it doesn't give the airbag. So your life, you will not save your life, or the passenger will not save their life. So that is the hard real-time operating system, right? Now, soft real-time system means what? It missing a deadline does not result the fatal consequence. If you received a message, or if it is received an after 2 hours message, but your life is not in a danger situation, that is a fatal consequence, right? Missing a deadline at maximum, it may lower the quality of services provided, but not catastrophic, right? Catastrophic. Quality of services is degraded, right? So network that quality of services. Suppose you are playing a DVD and that is stuck up there, the movies are not coming. So you are again taking back and pushing. So that is a soft real-time system, right? It could be a recover the losses, right? And those losses doesn't recover. That is a hard real-time system. Now, what are the difference between the hard and soft real-time system? A real-time system is the characterized by the need to meet the deadlines, right? Need to meet the deadlines. Hard real-time system. Task has to perform on the time. Within a time, there is no error and delay, and 100% has to perform, right? Missing a deadline result in a fatal consequence, right? An example, flight control system, right? So missing a deadline, it occurs the fatal consequence. Soft real-time system. Late compensation of the job is undesirable but not fatal, right? Means it is not create the fatal consequence, right? Missing a deadline may be the lower quality of service, right? It is lower quality of service provided but not the catastrophic, right? The music system, DVD player, it is the quality will degraded, but it is not the fatal consequence will occur within that, right? So that is the difference between the hard real-time operating system and the soft real-time operating system. Now I'll give the example of the hard real time system. Suppose if you are making a accident and airbag doesn't come, that means you are going to say miss your life. So this is a hard real time system. Suppose the wall is there, the pacemaker, this is generating the electrical signals, right? It is an artificial pacemaker wall. If these are not generating pulses, signals, pulses within that particular time, that means your life is in a danger mode. Your BP pulses are increasing and decreasing. So these are the pacemaker is a hard real-time operating system, which is connected to the your life. It is consequence, a fatal consequence will occur over here. Now this is real-time operating system. Suppose there are the breaking point, this is without real ABS system. Nowadays in your car all the ABS systems are there. These are the breaking point and these are the without ABS system. ABS system means what? It is sensing. Now this technology is used into the abroad. There is a carless driverless car. So these ABA technologies are used there. They sense the ABS and then it's work. This is without ABS means it's occur the accidents over there. This is missiles within that time, within that particular destination is sending. These are the hard operating systems example, right? Where you can use the operating systems, where you use the embedded platform. These all are the embedded platforms, right? This is the real flight control. It is a real-time operating system. All these are actuators, sensors are controlling by the operating system. That is a real-time operating system. Now, the soft real-time operating system. These are the hard real-time operating system. These all are. It has to perform within that time. Otherwise, you may lose. It will create the fatal consequence, right? And this DVD player is a soft real-time system. Game playing is a soft real-time system. Joystick, your washing machine is a soft real-time system. If it is not moving, it doesn't has a fatal consequently. It may repair, it may recover the things. So these are the soft real-time system. Now why required our operating system, real-time operating system? If it is not operating system, only program is written, that means your system is working as a single tasking system, right? Single task, there is no other task. That means you cannot, only one application will run at a one time, right? And multitasking, this only she is speaking, right? This is a single tasking, but this is what she is doing, it is a multitasking. At the same time, maximum n number of tasks has to perform, and for that it is sharing a resource. So here the multiple tasks is created for particular task, right? Here the single without orders, only one task can execute by CPU at a time, and this is called the single task system, right? Without ORTOS or without embedded operating system, only one task means only one while loops will execute, and that particular work will, your CPU will not be shared, your microcontroller will not be shared with the other another task, because it is a single tasking system, right? But whereas ORTOS allow to execute of multitasking on the single CPU, it is a multitasking on the single CPU. All tasks executed as if completed on entire CPU, right? The each and every task will get particular time slot for CPU, and again they are standing into the queue by accessing. So that operating systems are managing the CPU time, are managing the memory space, are managing the resource management and everything. So at the same time, multiple tasks can perform. So that is called the multitasking system. And this is possible with the help of embedded operating system and real-time operating system. Now, interrupt. In single task operating system, interrupt service routing are used for the real-time part, right? In case of single operating system and any hazardous is comes over there. So that part, hazardous is comes there, your system has to stop. Suppose the fire is there. So whatever the process is going to do, execute the task, that has to be a stop, and it takes the interrupt of fire detector or fire. So that has to manage with the help of interrupt service routing or user real-time parts for the application and critical operations. By critical operations, right? But multitasking is done by scheduler. It is task is scheduled for particular. We have seen into the practical also. We are creating the task, we are scheduling them, we are giving the priorities them. So it is standing into the queue management, queue creations, all these are we have seen into the our lab activities, right? So the multitasking is done by the scheduler in RTOS kernel, right? In RTOS means real-time operating system kernel. And the tasks are scheduler for executing according to its priority, right? So whatever the task has the priority, so for particular each and every application it is created the task, it is given the CPU will manage, operating system will manage the CPU time, and that schedule a task, which task is resumed, which task should dead, or which task is suspended. All these tasks are managed by the operating system, right? Single task system means what? Only one for loop are there. So it is managing whole this. And if any hazardous comes, so it goes to the interrupt and again come back, again execute. Again, it goes to the ISR routing. Again, it goes to the ISR. Super loop. So this is what called the loop within a loop, right? So this is particular task is performing. These are the single task system, right? One task is there and any hazardous comes, it goes to the service routing. After executing the service routing, again, it comes to the main where you have left that point. Again, your CPU will execute the code. If this ISR routing is here, here again, it's create the interrupt. Again, it goes. So inside that is called nested. Interrupt service routing means within that interrupt again the interrupt is created, right? So this is managed by the single task system, whereas in a multiple tasking system, in multiple tasking system CPU time is distributed among the different tasks, right? So now the task 1, task 2, task 3, task 4, n number of tasks, and all are switches over there. So this is we can called as, so this real-time kernel, these are the events. It is managing your switch is here. Now the CPU will execute the task. This, if your switch is moon here, your CPU will execute the task for this. If your switch is here, your CPU will execute the task for this. If switch is here, your CPU will execute the task for this. And so on, right? So it is like this multitasking system. And again, it is standing into the queue. But who is managing this switch? It is managing the kernel real-time operating system, right? It is managing the real-time kernels, right? So which task has to perform? And this is for as like a scheduling, suspend, resume, priorities. All these are parameters done by, measured by the operating system for that particular task. Now the single task system means it is the super loop design. Super loop design means what? Loop within a loop. So this is what loop and within a loop. So that is called the super loop design. It is classical way of designing the embedded system. It is a classical. Earlier we used to do and does not use the service for the real-time operating system. We are managing in a single way, right? No real-time kernel is used in a single task system. Like we have done the Ordinus program last fourth semester. So all these are the single task system. We have not used there the multitasking and all, right? So interrupt service routing are usually for the real-time part of the application in case of critical, right? In case of critical hazardous era. So ISR routing will manage that part, right? However, super loop can become a difficult to maintain if the program become too large and super complex integrations, right? So there are loop to loop, you have to manage. So it is very difficult to keep the track of that, ki which ISR is from which ISR. It is very difficult to manage the trackings. So it is however the super loop can become a difficult to maintain. Only 1-2 layer we can manage, but it is a 50 layer, 30 layer, 40 layer. It is very difficult to keep the managing that. So because of that, difficult to manage if the programs became large and use very complex interaction. So reaction time depends on the execution time is entire sequence. It is from 1-1 and that hierarchy is managing from last to second last to third, and then it comes to the main program. So it is very, the resulting is poor real-time behavior. It is very poor real-time behavior. Because if this is the interrupt service routing, now here it is a 50 layers. So now this to this, and again you are coming back to this. So whatever this real-time behavior is very, very poor. That drawback has to recover, and this type of system is typically used in a small, not the bigger level, and simple system or if the real-time behavior is not critical. It is not critical, it is a simple system. There we can use this a single task system, right? Daily uses program. But if it is in a flight, whatever the be seen the example of hard real-time system, so it is very difficult to use the single task system, right? Now the multitasking system is simplified. That single operating system means only one task is performed and hazardous is managed by ISR. But if it is a level of hazardous, it's very, very difficult to manage. So instead of that, it comes the multitasking system, and multitasking system is the behavior kind the kernel will manage each and every task to the CPU and the other resources devices, right? Now, scheduling in RTOS. How does the scheduling in RTOS? Scheduling is the process of distributing CPU time. Scheduling means what? It is a process of distributing CPU time among the different tasks, right? Scheduling means what? It is a process of distributing CPU time among all the tasks, right? It is equally as per their priority and this. So number of tasks, resource requirement, what are the resource requirement of that particular task, execution time, how much time it takes to execute this particular task, deadlines, what the deadline should meet, and what are the priority of tasks. So these are the five main components of scheduling of tasks in a RTOS, right? So today we have just seen the introduction of RTOS. RTOS means what? We have seen the what is operating system, whether it is a general or embedded operating system. The concept behind that, any operating system, it is interaction between the application and the hardware, right? Now, the real-time system means it has to perform within a particular time. that is a real time, means real time plus operating system. So that is called the RTOS, real time operating system. Now there are two types of real time operating system. One is hard real time operating system, another is the soft real time operating system. Now the hard real time operating system means what? That the deadline has to manage within a time, and it is 100% whatever the concurrency or whatever the conditions is there, but that deadline has to manage 100%. Soft real time system, it is not occur any fatal consequent, it could manage later on also. So the sum of the example, we have seen the hard real time system, that is the missile, aircraft, airbags and all, where the fatal consequent occur. So there it has a real time operating system. For example of music system, DVD player, it is a soft real time system. Right? Now the single task and multitask real time system, only one task is performing at the same time, and in case of any real or hazardous is occur, it is managed by ISR. But this is used for the small system, right? There are one or two level of the ISR. But if it is a bigger system, for example of the aircraft and missile, so it is layer to layer. It is very difficult to maintain the track of that. So it gives the poor performance of the real-time system. So instead of that, it uses the multitasking operating system. Multitasking, when it is comes to the multitask manage, so it comes to the operating system. Who is managing all the CPU times, all the schedulings and all? This is the kernel operating system, which is a layer between your applications and hardware. So these operating systems are managing the CPU time for the particular task, and that is managing that time with the help of scheduling. So scheduling has this the five components, that is a number task, resource management, executions time and deadlines, and the priority. Which task has that priority? Highest, lowest, middle waste, it's change the priority. If it is all these are thinking for that particular dedicated system. So real-time operating systems are used for the embedded operating system. And as you know, embedded operating system or embedded system is performed that particular devices. All we have seen, missile is also one kind of embedded system. Aircraft is also one kind of embedded system. Washing machine is also one kind of embedded system. Microwave is also one kind of embedded system. These all are the embedded system. Only computers are for that, they required a particular dedicated operating system, right? So some of the example are the hard real-time operating system, some of the example are the soft real-time operating system. So thank you girls, I hope you have clear your RTOS concept, and if you have any query, you can raise your questions. Thank you, girls.